My name is Jolanta Gelumbeckaitė, and I am an extraordinary professor of Baltic linguistics at the Goethe-University Frankfurt on Main.
And I'm Jurgis Pakerys from Vilnius University. I work at the Department of Baltic Linguistics, and I love studying Baltic languages.
The Lithuanian accent is free and mobile. Any syllable can be stressed. I'll read it loud. Listen. Likime, let us stay. Likime, or faith. Likime, in faith. As you see, short stressed syllables are marked with grave accent. Thus, grave accent just marks simple stress. The accent in Lithuanian is realized as pitch. In Lithuanian, the pitch accent is combined with tonal oppositions. These tonal oppositions basically rest on underlying moraic structure. It means that every long vowel or diphthong may be defined as a bimoric sequence. They form the basis for an opposition of pitch accent. Lithuanian retained the difference between athematic and thematic verbs. Athematic endings do not differ from the thematic ones in the first and second plural person. In the third person, there is no numerous opposition. In modern Lithuanian, most athematic verbs inflect as simple thematic verbs. The endings show a high degree of fusion with thematic vowels, like in nominal case.
For the transitive clauses, modern Lithuanian follows simply the order SVO, while in Old Lithuanian, both SOV and SVO orders are found. So, when original text, that is, non-translated text in Old Lithuanian are considered, such as some introductions to a famous work, Margarita Theologica, verb final order is more frequent, according to the data of Vytautas Ambrazas. Apie atajimą viešpaties Kristaus ir jojimą ant karalystės savos. Mateušiep 20. pirmoj kapituloj. So it's about arrival of the Lord Christ and riding into his kingdom in the 21st chapter of Matthew. Dėkuojam tau su linksma širdžia. So I thank you with a joyous heart. Bye-bye.